एवरीवन, डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई डॉक्टर आर डी पाटिल, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी, वसंतराव नाईक आर्ट्स साइंस एंड कॉमर्स कॉलेज शहादा। टुडे आई टीचिंग द पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक्स ऑफ टी वाई बी एस सी जूलॉजी कोर्स नंबर पेपर 6 जू 506A पेस्ट मैनेजमेंट्स। इन दिस कोर्स I discuss in two lectures syllabus as well as subtopics, that is first introduction about the pest. In this topic we discuss about the definition and concepts of the pest. Out of these units, the second topics is 1.2 is a classification of the pest. In classification of pest, we have already discussed about the 5 types of the pest. Out of this 5 pests, 3 pests already explained in the first lectures. Now remaining 2, that is these 5 types of the pest, remaining 2, that is the 4th is the public health pest. Dear friends, in this types of the pest, his name is the public health pest. Our relation for your names, that is a public. In public health pest means already in Marathi is also called as a Sarvajanik Arogya. The particular, the insects which are transmitting the pathogen and causing various diseases in man are called as a public health pest. It is also called as a vectors. Vectors are those type of the insects which are transmit the disease from one organism to the another organism. In public health pest, few more examples, that is the mosquitoes, sand flies, black flies, house flies is the most important examples to are transmitting the disease from one organism to the another organism. And last is the fifth types of the pest, that is a structural pest. It is same for your name, that is structural. Structural pest is also called as a damaging the structure, means in this type of the pest, the insects which damage to wooden frames, doors, furnitures, library books, stored papers, cardboard and all other wooden articles and components of the buildings are called as a structural pest. Means the any kinds of the materials which are made by the wood, that is also called the furniture or structures, which damaging this type of the pest. In this type of the pest is the example is the wood termites. Second is the silver fish, also the cloth moths. It's called a carpet beetles. This type of the insect pests are damaging the particular as by the wooden frames, doors, library books and cardboards. So this is a brief description by the 5 types of the pest in the first unit. In a second subunit, that is 1.2, is a classification of pest with respect to the systemic position, mark of identification, life cycle, nature of damage and control measure. This is the main 5 points which are consulted to related as in a point number 2. That is, there are the 5 types of the pest are also included in this category or these units. Out of these 5, one by one types of the pest are explained to get by the with examples. In first type of the pest, that is a agricultural pest, we have already discussed about the agricultural pest. Agricultural pest means nothing but this type of the pest, the insects which are effects or attacking on the crop of the field. This type of the pest is called as a agricultural pest. It is also called a crop pest. So in agricultural pest, Examples are get, his name, first is a paste of cotton, or paste of cotton is a many more paste out of which in your syllabus to get by the red cotton bugs. The red cotton bugs, his scientific name is the Desidericus cingulatus. Mainly this type of the pest are mainly your host plants, that is a cotton. Next is a bhindi. Third one is ambadi and other plants of the plants which are included in the Malvaceae family plants. These plants also mainly attack. So the red cotton bugs, in a systemic position point of view or classification point of view, phylum is the Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Hemiptera, family Pyrrhocoridae, genus Desidericus, and species is Cingulatus. So the combined or scientific name of this pest is the Desidericus cingulatus. This pest, you have also seen your pictures as well as your photographs, to locally found in the growing cotton area or attacking by this pest by the red cotton bugs. Second point is the mark of identification. So in this point, how you identify or give the identification of the red cotton bugs in particular view. The mark of identification point of view, the adults are 1 centimeter long and pale straw color body, head with a long beak like roof on the back. The female bears a pair of anal tufts. Nymphs are waxy white in color. So the adult bugs measures about 12 to 50 mm in length. The females are longer, that is 15 mm, than the males is a 12 mm. It is a blood red in color except eyes, scutellum, anal style, and antennae, which are black colored. Besides, there is a black spot on each of the membranous forewings. A series of white transverse bands are present on the ventral side of the abdomen. Mouth parts are adapted of this type of the pest are the piercing and sucking type of the mouth parts. The nymphs are smaller than adults and are wingless. Next point is the life cycle of the red cotton bugs. So the every animals, your life cycle is completed by the 3 to 4 stages in your life cycle. In red cotton bugs, life cycles are completed into the eggs, nymph. Nymph has a 5 instar and later on the convert to adult. There are the 3 stages. So life cycle of the pest or insects are completed by the 4 stages, that is the eggs, larva, pupa, and adult. This type of the life cycle or is also called as a complete metamorphosis, or few more in case of the animals, eggs, nymph, and adult. This type of the metamorphosis is called incomplete type of the metamorphosis. So in this pest of the red cotton bugs, the life cycle is incomplete. The female starts laying eggs after a pre-oviposition period of 11 to 20 days. Eggs are laid in cluster of 20 to 25 on the under the surface of leaves covered with a waxy material. A single female lays at 600 to 800 eggs during its lifespan. The eggs are small, light blue, and ovoid in shape. They hatch in 7 to 12 days. The newly hatched nymphs is a pale brown with a pair of long wax covered canal processes. The nymph grows up sucking sap from leaves, passing through 5 instars in 20 to 30 days. The average life of adult female is 6 to 8 weeks and male is 4 to 6 weeks. In 1 year, 3 to 4 generations are completed of this pest. The different or various stages of the life cycles are seen in the life cycle of red cotton bugs. First is the eggs. Eggs also has through the nymph stage, that is the first nymph, second nymph, it also called instar. In specifically, after a small nymph or large nymphs, we are converted to the adult. Adult red cotton bug as similar to the nymph, but nymph is a wingless and immature, but adult is also has a complete maturation and also wings are completely developed. So red cotton bugs are specifically to conversion or starting from eggs, nymph stages, or directly form or convert into the adult forms. Adult form is severe damaging for the cottons. Next point in your life cycle of the red cotton bugs is the nature of damage. Mainly in this point, the pest is causing severe damage. In nature of damage is nothing but the which type of the harmful effects are creating by the red cotton bugs on the crop. In Marathi it is called as a nuksan. Kutla kutla prakarche nuksan te karu shaktat ba yachyamadhye apan te baghu shakto. Karan pratyek pest ha tya farm madhe kya shetamadhye je kahi economic crop asil tyanna kasha prakarche loss te karu shaktat te apan ya point madhye baghto. The nature of damage of red cotton bugs in this point, both nymphs and adults suck the cell sap from leaves and tender shoots and impair vitality of plants. Means in this specific stage, the nymphs and adults are damaging to leaves or shoots. Shoot means chala apan kode pane mhanto ya kode pane na dekhil tya tikani he red cotton bugs nymph stage आणि ॲडल्ट फॉर्ममध्ये दोघं त्याच्यावर अटॅक करून त्याच्याला सेल सॅप ते सक करू शकतात. इन द सेकंड इट इज सिवियर टू अटॅक बॉल्स ओपन बॅडली अँड द लिंट ऑफ द पुअर क्वालिटी. एक्स्पेशली इन दिस पॉईंट द रेड कॉटन बग्स आर अटॅकिंग मेनली ॲज अ कॉटन बॉल अँड इन कॉटन बॉल we have not a naturally brushed, means the cotton ball after complete maturation to get by the brushed and release the cotton easy, but this type of the pest are attacking on cotton ball. We also lint is a poor, means the quality of the extraction of the cotton from the cotton ball is not easy. It attaching or affecting to naturally releasing by the cottons, by the red cotton bugs. In addition, they also feed on the seeds and lower their oil content. Means the red cotton bugs are eating the oil seeds are present in the cotton. We also extracting the oil and to get low percentage of the seeds to oil extraction and also get the loss the germination power of the seeds or get by the low germination. The lint is stained by the excreta of the bugs or their body juice as they are crushed in the ginning factory. Means the red cotton bug specific laying eggs also attaching to the cotton. At the time of the crushing, the cotton natural form is disturbed and white colors also get by the linty hairs. Means we also tela se dark padtat tya cotton madhe ja paddhatine naturally white color madhe nighal pael tasa nikta tya tikani red cotton bug cha paste ne tela lint kelyamule tya tikani tyache ginning process hotana crush hon jatat ani yenara ja cotton fiber astat tyachyamadhe aplyala dark distat. Next is the control measures. Control measure is nothing but the controlling the pest which are not spreading the excess loss of cotton crop of the farmer. So control method is most important. Each and every insect pest which are affecting on the cotton, we are controlling by the three methods. First is the primary control methods. Primary control methods in Marathi it is called the Pratham Upchar, or Pratham stage. We are controlling by the pest. In this primary control measures, cotton field should be plowed to expose eggs to sunlight. Means it is also called as Shetat, किंवा शेतातले पिकं घेतल्या गेल्यानंतर त्या ठिकाणी चांगल्या पद्धतीने नांगरटी करणे. नांगरटी केल्यानंतर त्या ठिकाणी त्या जमिनीची माती खालतीवरती होऊन त्याच्यात काही ह्या पेजचे लाईफ सायकल स्टेजेस असतील, एग्जला नीम, ते त्या ठिकाणी दाबले जातात किंवा डिस्टर्ब होऊन सनलाईटच्या प्रखर प्रकाशामध्ये ते मरून जातात. इट इज कॉल्ड द प्रायमरी कंट्रोल मेजर्स. नेक्स्ट इज द इन्सेक्ट शुड बी हँड पिकड अँड किल्ड इन kerosene water. In this is a primary control measures. Few amount or limited amount of the red cotton bugs are also seen in your cotton crop or field to collecting your hand and to collect to kerosene water and damage this type of the pest in your particular area of the farm to digging the hole and get the pore to this insect pest. In third control measures by the primary methods, the crops of bhindi should be shown as a trap crop and pest collected there should be destroyed. Many more times the local farmers or in your experience baryatda apan mhanto shetkari diwali la shana hoto tasha paddhatine aplya purvajanna kya junya anubhavi shetkaryanna jar apan vicharla ki eka shetamade punna punna te double te peak repeat te karat nahi, yache karan asa asta की त्याच प्रकारच्या कॅटेगरीतल्या पेशीतले पेस्ट असतील त्यांची त्या ठिकाणी डॉर्मंट स्टेज किंवा त्यांचे निम्फ एग्स तिथे जमिनीत असतात आणि पुन्हा त्याच कॅटेगरीचं त्याच सेम फॅमिलीचं क्रॉप जर आपण कल्टिवेट केलं तर त्याच्यावर हे पेस्ट लवकर अटॅक करतात. म्हणून रोटेशन सिस्टीम आपण त्याला म्हणतो. वी हॅव द चेंजिंग द एक्सचेंज ऑफ द क्रॉप, मीन्स सेम पेसीज सेम कॅटेगरी ऑफ द क्रॉप्स आर नॉट यिल्डिंग in this same place of farm because we are easy to attacking the life cycle stages of the same crop pest. Second method of the control measures is the chemical control measures. In chemical control measures we directly we have also already known the specific type of the chemical, that is a pesticides or insecticides are used to controlling the pest population of the red cotton bugs. In a chemical control methods, the farmers are spraying with CVN as a specific chemical or pesticides, heptacolor or methyl parathions. These type of the chemicals pesticides are used by the farmer to spraying the cotton crop and also control the red cotton bug population. And last method is also as a biological control methods. In biological control methods, it also called controlling or it is called the living words, living methods. Means in this type of the methods, in Sanskrit it is called as a jivo jivas jivanam. Ek jiv ko ek sajiv dusrya sajivala control karto. Asha prakarcha method madhe eka sajivacha sahayane dusrya sajivacha harmful effect insect population control karne. So in short it is called as a prey and predator system. Means prey or predators. Predators are feeding on the prey and automatically the harmful insect populations are controlling. In the red cotton bug pest or Desiderata cingulatus, the biological control methods, anti-locus coacoperti and Herpactor coastalis, this specific category of the biological insects are controlling or predators are used to controlling the red cotton bugs specific stages which are harmful effects are attacking by this type of the biological animals and to control the naturally of this population by the red cotton bug pest. So in this units there are the few most also are the examples to get by the study point of view, but today we complete the one pest, that is red cotton bugs. In next lectures to complete the remaining pest which are study point of view, we study this pest in next lecture. Thank you.